Hello and welcome everyone. So in the previous video, we were talking about setting up the Docker Compose. So we can see we have a Docker Compose and Docker file. Now what we can do is we can just do a Docker Compose up. So if already your containers are up, then you can just do a Docker Compose down. You can also do a Docker container pruning. If you're already some container is accessing some port, then it will clean out all the other Docker containers. Even you can do a Docker volume pruning. So it will wipe out our data, which is stored for MySQL, because we want to start from fresh. So now we can do Docker Compose up, and from here, we can also get the clear picture, what all services are up. So you can see MySQL is up, Node.js is starting. So there are many advantages of using Docker. I mean, first of all, your machine configuration should be good enough, so it should not struggle. Otherwise, you can install MySQL, and in your code, when you are going to communicate to MySQL, you can just provide localhost instead of MySQL. If you have a local installation of MySQL, now you can see, if you can see this message, we are able to connect to a MySQL. Not connect, I mean MySQL initially, we just need to start it again. And our Node.js started, because currently we are not connecting with MySQL, so both are independent. And now Node.js and MySQL are starting. We can connect to a Node.js container using this right click. So you can install this plugin, which will give you an access to talk to your Docker container. You can see I have all the files here. And what we are doing is, so we will be using this Docker container to run a lot of things, like we will be executing the migrations, we'll be doing a DB sync from this Docker container. So this will be helpful. We have to go into the Docker containers, and then we will need to talk to MySQL for running the migration seeders and all. So this is about how we are running the Docker containers. Now, in the next section, next thing what we are going to do is we'll start creating the MVC model. MVC model means we are going to create you can say controllers, the routes and all. So in the app.index.ts, currently we don't have anything. So here we have API routes. API routes are nothing, it's not registering to anywhere. So when route.use API v1 user, it is pointing to the user, and user route is not having anything. So here we will do router.get. Here there will be some request, and we'll be just using some controller, like user controller. And we'll be creating the user controller inside app. Okay, so this is how we will be just accessing user controller and some method, which we will build. Some method, and we'll be passing the request response. Request is of type express request, response is of type express response. We'll define the types and all. So now we are going to create a controller inside this app. We can create a controller. And we can also have services, FS controller modules, and we can also create services. Okay, all these things. Now you can just do Docker Compose up, everything is bootstrapped in the environments. What we are going to do is we are going to have all the MySQL configurations also, so that our MySQL database connection service we are going to use, that should be able to get all the MySQL variables from the service. Okay, so in next video we will try to establish a connection with the MySQL, and we'll wrap up all the controllers and services.